Okay, as you can see here, I've got all the skirt boards in, and I do have to trim this last piece. I have to trim this end of it to go with the wheel well, and I have to trim the back end of it to match up. But of course, before I can do that, I need to get this piece of flooring in, okay? And I know what I'm matching up to. That'll be next. But I've temporarily screwed this bottom skirt in, skirt board, and same on the other side. And what I will do is when I get finished putting the floor in, back in, which I'm going to do next, then I'll go ahead and put the metal back on, and I will make some marks, pull this piece of skirt, trim it, and put it back in. I'll do the same on the other side. That way I don't have to trim the metal. I'd rather trim the wood. Over here we've done the same thing, as you can see. Okay. And once that's finished, the floor is in. I do a little bit more framing to make it sturdy for the bed. We can start buttoning up the rear, and then I can go for the top. Because in less than a week, we're going to be putting the top on this trailer. And the top on this trailer, the Shasta. We're going to do them side by side, right next to each other. That'll be fun. Okay, as you can see, what I did was I hung the piece of aluminum, the bottom piece. And just at the top there. Put two staples in it to hold it. And what I've done is I've scribed where I need to cut this bottom skirt, the skirt board. So, done it on both ends. See, I did it over here. So now I'm going to cut that with a jigsaw, and I'm going to do it right in place. I'm not even going to take it off. Got all the screws in, so I'm just going to cut it in place. Okay, so there it is. There's this side. Got the plywood in for the new rear part of the floor. Tomorrow morning, we'll do the same thing over here. Get this piece back on. And then we can start working on paneling and framing the rear and get it buttoned up. We'll pull the top panel, then we'll be ready, and we'll replace that top panel, and then we'll be ready for the top, and then the rear skin. We'll be done with this one. All right, let's take a look here. I've got everything in, including the starter board, and this is what I call starter board, the place where you attach the paneling all the way across the bottom. Whether it's front or rear, you have one of these. So I glued that in. It's drying, got it all clamped up. I'll put some screws in it later. And then it'll be ready for paneling and framing. So, you know, all this rotten stuff gone now. So the structure is strong again, where you have structural integrity again. I replaced the bottom floor framing, as you can see, on both sides. The middle was okay. It wasn't eaten up. But, it was, you know, it didn't get any termites. Most of this rot was, a little of it was moisture, but most of it was termites. Luckily, they didn't get through the entire trailer. Otherwise, this trailer was so close to a frame-up rebuild. It's not funny. I mean, it probably would have been better off doing that, but not everybody has the capabilities to do a frame-up rebuild, or the desire, or the money. Sometimes it can be more expensive. Now, it does need carriage bolts in the rear. I got to straighten that frame out over there a bit, and then we'll put some carriage bolts in it. But I wanted to show you everything before I put the outside skin back on. So, as you can see, I use a combination of screws and pieces of aluminum for my joints for strength. I put screws in everywhere, and then other places like around the windows and stuff I also use some metal. So there it is, all structurally sound again. So now we're going to put this piece of metal on, and I'm going to call it a day. It's Sunday. I'm done for the day. Now there's really nothing that you can, not much you can gain from what I'm about to show you, but I thought you might get a kick out of watching me struggle. Because I very seldom have any help. I got the other piece of aluminum on, and now I'm going for this one. Did it all by myself. And I was thinking, oh, I should have videoed this, but usually when I turn on the camera, that's when everything goes wrong. So we'll see. If I start having too much of a hard time and want to cuss and everything, I'm in too good of a mood for that. So if that happens, I'll turn the camera off. We're going to see how this goes. I've already had this piece of metal on once. I took it back off to do some other things, but I've already had it on once. The main thing is I just need to have my gun near me where I can grab it so I can shoot a staple or two. And I'm going to put that in here so it's easy to grab. There. Like I say, once you learn how to handle the metal, you get used to it, not quite so bad. And I just want to make sure that you clear everything. So everything goes back together well. You got everything lined up properly. Just a little over to the left. A bit far. Damn, up high enough on the left. Up high enough on the right. But again, it feels like it's a little bit to the left too far. So I'm going to drag it back just a bit more. Oh, that wasn't too bad, was it? So we've got the left side in as high as it'll go. Put a staple where it will be hidden, around the window. Sure, this side is up all the way. Staple in there to hold it. Down there to hold it. And the one for the window. You don't need too many staples. I'll put more staples in later, but I'm gonna get all the screws in first. The screws are really what's supposed to hold all this. And I might have to take it out again. I don't think so, but you just never know. I messed with that one. There. Pull that staple out. It's in. That'll hold it until I get all the trim on and screws in and stuff. And if it needs any more staples, I'll give it more staples. Nice, huh? There's a little piece that goes all the way across the bottom there too, under the door. Can't believe that went in so easy with the camera on. Not usually the case. There's the pole that I shove up through the vent hole normally and make a tent-like, teepee-like shape out of the tarp. That's so runoff actually runs off and doesn't puddle up on top of the trailer. Now, the vent hole is a little bit bigger than it used to be. Yeah. We're replacing all this paneling. It's about 1.5 panels. I think it's about 6 feet, whatever it is. It's less than two, but more than one. Yeah. So we'll put new paneling and new framing in tomorrow. Get it all ready for the new top, which is going to come next week. I'll have it Friday. Tomorrow's Tuesday. I'm a little ahead of schedule, but that's okay because I want to get the Shasta ready for its top too. That gives me a day or two to work on that before the other roof comes. So, yeah. Now, of course, what this is all leading up to is to show you people how to put a new metal roof on your trailer. And I decided to do the two of these side by side. So I'm just going to do a whole bunch of video and then edit it all together later. But I will have that video out here pretty soon. Because like I say, on the 10th of January, the new roof for this one shows up. I'm going to install it. Start installing it on the 11th. I should have it all framed and ready by then. And then we'll move right over the Shasta and do the same thing. But yeah, every time I end up with these panels missing out of the ceiling, it makes me think about, ooh, how neat it would be to have a skylight that big and be able to watch shooting stars from inside your trailer. But it'd just be another big giant hole to leak. Hope it doesn't rain tonight. Doesn't look like rain. Okay, let's go over a couple of things here, just for your learning experience. this is not a complete restore, as you know, as far as my part's concerned anyway. But just want to go over a couple little things again, even though all this stuff is in my other videos on the Shasta and the DeVille. You don't use screws on this radius here, because, and the same in the front. You don't use the screws and the pocket hole jig because there's a radius here. Now it's over here, but here it's kind of flat. But you can see how this board is turned in, okay, at an angle. And the same with this bottom one is turned in at the bottom. This one's turned in at the top because of the radius. But the window is flat, so you need a flat surface to screw the window to. So when we make these connections, we use pieces of metal. These are just, you know, extra metal that I have lying around. I cut strips and I staple them in. And that's pretty much the same as the staples that they used back then. But they used staples instead of doing it this way. Well, actually, they used a combination of both, depending on the factory and the type of trailer. So just wanted to mention that. We're getting ready to put the roof on. And now I've got all the framing done for the top, for the roof, as far as I need to go, and the paneling in. It would be nice if I could get this bottom piece of paneling in tomorrow and the edge board. This is edge board, by the way. That's what they called it in the factories. I call it curbing, but they called it edge board. So let's call it edge board, curbing, aka curbing, aka edge board. I'd like to get the bottom panel here in. I have the starter board right there, okay? That's the starter board. That's something to fasten the bottom of the paneling together all the way across the bottom. And then another board gets sandwiched. And once we get that on there, another board gets sandwiched on top of it. So at any rate, that's on the outside to hold it in there. You've seen that in the other videos too, like the 54 Westerner, I showed that. So at any rate, I would like to get this piece of paneling in. I've got some things I've got to do down here first. We'll see how the day goes. But yeah, it would be nice to get the paneling in, get the edge board on, and then go with the roof. I can't really see if this is filming very well in there, but you can see there's the interior with the new paneling.